नमस्कार, आप सभी लोग अपने अपने घरों पर सकुशल होंगे। इसी कामना के साथ लेट्स मूव टू टॉक अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज द ट्रांसलेशंस। एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द जेनेटिक कोड्स एंड द डिफरेंट फीचर डिफरेंट साइलेंट फीचर्स ऑफ द जेनेटिक कोड्स एंड द फॉर्मेशन एंड द अडेप्टिव मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ द ट्रांसफर आरएनए। लेट्स मूव द मेन टॉपिक, दैट इज द ट्रांसलेशन। मीन्स जनरली वी टॉक अबाउट द ट्रांसलेशन, एज इन द ट्रांसक्रिप्शन द चेंजेस ऑफ द डीएनए इन टू द आरएनए इन प्रोकैरियोट्स एंड यूकैरियोट्स, एज वेल एज फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ द प्रोटीन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज सब्सटेंसेज, विद द हेल्प ऑफ द पॉलीपेप्टाइड थिंग्स और विद द हेल्प ऑफ द अमीनो एसिड्स। मीन्स द कन्वर्जन ऑफ दीज अमीनो एसिड्स इन द पॉलीपेप्टाइड or the proteins, that is known as the translation. If we talk about especially in this process, or you can say the polymerization process of the amino acid to the formation of the polypeptide, that is the protein. Means with the help of the amino acids, when the polypeptide can be formed or the protein will form, that is known as the translation. Especially we can say that the different order and the sequences of the amino acids which can be defined by the sequence of base pair in the messenger RNA, or you can say the amino acids are joined by the bond which is generally known as polypeptide bond. Means different amino acids can be attached to each other, or they are again bonded to each other by the bond, that is known as the polypeptide bond. And this is for the making of this bond or attachment of these new amino acids, they will require the energy that is always utilized by the ATP in the formation of ATP. And for the formation of the or for the process of the translation, the different things, different main components which are participated in that protein synthesis, they can be needed, that is RNAs, that is messenger RNA, transfer RNA and ribosomal RNA, and ribosomes and some enzymes which are necessary for the such condition. Evenly they can also requirements of the ATP energy, as well as the in the formation of the transfer RNA, it needed the adapter molecule of RNA, transfer RNA, and the amino acyl transfer RNA synthesis enzyme for the changing of the transfer RNA. So let's move to start our process, that is the different phases of the translations. First of all, there is a special structures that is known as the activation of amino acids. It can be occurs in the presence of ATP and link of their cognate transfer RNA in the presence of the amino acetylase synthesis enzyme, which can be always help for the charging of the transfer RNA to the, or you can say charging of transfer RNA or the amino acetylation, that is known as amino acetylation process of the tRNA. Means that can be transferred in different ways in different enzymes. Directly we can say when the two such transfer RNAs are brought closer together, formation of peptide bonds and between them would occur energetically in the presence of the catalyst. Especially don't be just confused, especially for the these processes, the first of all the charging RNAs or the amino acylation of the transfer RNA, two are come together. As you can just see in the diagram, you can see that these are the two diagrams over there. Means they can be always come together. When they will come together, only that conditions the polypeptide bond can be formed between the different amino acids, and it will always helpful for the doublementing of the peptide chain. So how this chain can be initiated, how this chain can be started over there? For that, first of all we can say the initiations of the polypeptide synthesis occurs in the ribosomes. Means this polypeptide synthesis can be started in the ribosomes. As you all know that ribose, the saved bug units of the ribose in eukaryotes and prokaryotes, there are two types. One is larger one and second one is the smaller one. So they can participate it for the doublementing of this one. That's why if you already known that ribosomes is known as the protein factory of any cell, right? So that process can be always take place inside the ribosomes. Especially we can say, first of all, The ribosomes, which can be considered as structural RNAs, and about 18 different proteins. Right? So for that, in such a conditions, when the inactive state is exist two subunits of the ribosome, that is large unit and a small unit. Large unit we can say that is 50S, or the small unit that is 30S of that one. When the subunit, when the small subunit can be comes over there, right, of the ribosomes, and it can able to forms the different sites over there, that it may be on the upper side of messenger RNA, there is a large unit will come over there. So first of all, the small unit can encounter with the messenger RNA, and this is the process of the translation of messenger RNA will start. It means whenever the first messenger RNA will strike it or encounter with the smaller unit of ribosomes, later on the second site of the large subunit, where is the three sites are found over there, especially generally two sites we have to talk about, there's a P site and the A site. Especially for that, the P A sites is generally you can say where these amino acids or transfer RNAs can attach together or comes closer to and engulf, right? And P site is the site where the binding of this polypeptide chain will occurs over there. So the such whenever the these transfer RNAs receptor molecule can to closer in the A sites, and after in the P site they can be just have to bind, or the sequences amino acids to bind to, and thus it can be form the polypeptide chain over there. And in the same time, we can say the small subunit of transfer RNA or that during the ribosomes, it can be attached to the large subunit in such a way that the initiation codon AUG come to P site. You have to remember, generally in that particular conditions, that particular phase, especially in that particular conditions, you have to know that first of all, that the small unit and the large unit of these ribosomes can be attached in such a way when that the P site places, there is always a anticodon or initiation codon, that is called AUG, come should be always at the P site over there, right? And after that, the messenger RNA also have the some additional sequences that are not translated, and these are the referred to as the untranslated regions, that is called UTR. Untranslated regions are also found over there. So you can say there are present at the both ends, that 5 prime end, right, before the started codons, and 3 prime end after the stop codons. Means generally there are lots of, you can say, sequences, additional sequences, which are untranslated regions, which are before the 5 prime and the after the 3 prime, there is a stop codon, that is, you can say, UUA, right? And this way, the translation process will going to be start. After that, there is another process, right, which can be found over there. In that particular conditions, you can say, especially the different activations of amino acids and different things can be participated over there. Later on, in the next part, or we can say after initiations polypeptide chains, there is another thing, that is the elongations of the polypeptide chain will occurs in that particular condition. But how this polypeptide chain can be elongated, means how it can be going to be become a larger one. For that, you have to know that elongation of polypeptide change, it can be occur when the second transfer RNA change into an appropriate amino acids bind to A site of the ribosomes, right? As well as we can say a polypeptide bond, that is CONNS, formed between the carboxylyl group and methionine, and the amino group, that is second amino acid, that reaction catalyzed by the enzyme that is called peptidylase transferase enzyme, which can be always reaction between them. Evenly, we can say the complexes composed of an amino acids like linked to transfer RNA and sequentially bind to the appropriated codons in the messenger RNA, means sequentially 5 prime to 3 prime may डायरेक्शन में ये अमीनो एसिड क्या होते हैं, ऐड होते चले जाते हैं वन बाय वन, राइट, एंड दे आर ट्रांसलेटेड इनटू पॉलीपेप्टाइड सीक्वेंसेस एंड डिक्टेटेड बाय द डीएनए एंड द रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द मैसेंजर आरएनए, मीन दे कैन बी ऑलवेज अटैच इन दैट पर्टिकुलर कंडीशंस ड्यू टू व्हिच इट कैन बी फॉर्म सच अ स्ट्रक्चर्स लेटर ऑन आफ्टर दैट पर्टिकुलर कंडीशंस द टर्मिनेशन ऑफ पॉलीपेप्टाइड मीन्स हाउ दिस पॉलीपेप्टाइड सेंसर कैन बी टर्मिनेटेड means this A, P and there is another one more side that is called E side where from where they can be terminated over there. So for that this transmissions of the polypeptide synthesize when they can be released factor bind to be stop codons means generally the when the transfer RNA can bind to the stop codons the process will be going to be break one now. And as the result of polypeptide synthesis, elongation process stops and releasing the complete polypeptide from the ribosomes. Means all the parts, messenger RNA, both unit of the transfer RNA and both unit of the ribosomes, they can be all break down. Only polypeptide change, which can be changes into the protein that can be formed over there. So this way, the translation will be occurs especially in that particular condition. In that, as I already told you, that especially any stop codon, that is you can say AUG, UAG or UGA, any will come in the A side and after that, that will stop. Mainly in that particular codons, the transfer RNA cannot recognize the stop codons. So due to which the process of transfer RNA at the P side release polypeptide and presence of the releasing factor, right, which is bind stop codons, or directly we can say, so this, the dissociation of the complex take place over there and the formation of the protein will generally completed over there. As you can just see this whole process, how this can be occurred over there. So you can just see in the diagrams here represented with the help of, as you can say, this is the transfer RNA molecule, adapter molecule, right, and you can say there is a, this is the messenger RNA. And these are the subunits of the ribosome subunits over there. So first of all, this will over there and it will attach like over there, that AUG will always comes in the A sites over there. And after that, this ribosome subunit can attach both of them. And after that, you can just see in the diagram, the first of all, these are the different sites of that one, right? This is the, this A site and P site, and the one more site is also over there, which I have told you already, untranslated regions are found over there. So this process will occur, and after that you can just see that AUG is the starting codon are found over there in the ribosomal, which is always found into the P site. This was the P site and this is the A site where this process will take place, right? So this, there is a, this starting codon is found and that molecule of the transfer RNA will come over there, and as you melatonin amino acid are found there. Later on, when this AUU will attach to the A site condition over there, and it can be attached over there. Later on, due to some specific catalytic enzymes, it can be found over there. Means this amino acid is just attached to this one over there, and this transfer adapter molecule will transfer over here again this way, because this RNA will moving like this one in both sides of this messenger RNA. So there is a bond between the melatonin and leonin. These amino acids, they will form a, especially you can say they will form a polypeptide bonds between them, and so they both are attached to each other. So this way sequentially, and later on from the E sites, the transfer RNA can be released from there, and this way this process will continue with joining over there, right? But later on when there is a, these stopping codons will come over there, due to which, like you can say, just in this condition, this is the stop codons are formed over there, and at the P site, the total long polypeptide changes attached with the help of the polypeptide bonds over there. So after the stopping codon, this process is stopped, and they all will just, releasing factor can be found over there, and this all can be breakdown over there. And so this transfer RNA will go there. Sorry. दिस ट्रांसफर आरएनए विल मूव दिस राइबोसोम लार्ज यूनिट स्मॉल यूनिट में आरएनए एंड देन वी विल गेट अ पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन लाइक दिस सो इट विल फॉर्म्स एज द जनरल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्रोटीन एंड दिस इज द सीक्वेंशियल प्रोसेस थ्रू विच इट कैन बी फाउंड ओवर देयर सो दिस वे इफ यू कैन डायरेक्टली अगेन सीन यू कैन जस्ट सीन इन दिस फिगर द प्रोसेस विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हेयर इनिशिएशन कोडोन आर फाउंड ओवर देयर Right, UAG we started, or the AUG from here. This way, the whole process will take place, and the complete synthesizing of the process will take place. Means if it can start from over there, this is the first position. Then you can just see in the second position, the it will comes in the P sites. Then one more adaptive molecule of with the amino acid transfer RNA will come over there in that positions. This way, this process will continuously and have. At the end, it will capable to form a polypeptide chain where the synthesis of protein will take place in that particular conditions, right? I can just show you with the animated diagram over here how this translation process will also take place. You can just see over there. You can just see in the diagram, this is the messenger RNA. This is the messenger RNA and this is the small unit, subunit of the ribosomes and this is the coming with the amino acids that is transfer RNA. When the large subunit and the small subunit is attached just like a way that it can be always the different sites. As you can see in the diagram, especially these are the three sites. That is the A site, this is P site and this is the E site. Where the attachment of the adapter molecules of messenger RNA will come here. And the first of all, it can be always come as you can see. आप इसमें देख रहे होंगे कि सबसे पहले जो transfer RNA आया वो कहाँ पे attach हुआ? वो हुआ आपके AUG यानी कि starting codon पे. अब ये second आपका codon आया है anticodon end से इसके CCG के साथ GGC के साथ attach हो गया. Later on इसके बाद आप देख रहे होंगे कि the attachment ये जो breakdown हुआ आपका amino acid का और ये क्या हुआ आपके proline के साथ जुड़ गया. अब धीरे से जैसे जैसे राइबोसोम आगेगा ये साइट चेंज होगी और यहाँ से आपका ये प्रीवियस जो अमीनो एसिड ट्रांसफर था वो इलोंगेट कर देगा. हर बार ये प्रोसेस जो डेवलपमेंटिंग होगी ये पी साइट्स ए साइट पे हमेशा इनिशिएशन करेगा. जैसे इनिशिएशन हुआ इस इनिशिएशन के तुरंत बाद सेम कंडीशन में फिर से अटैचमेंट के बाद यहाँ फिर पॉलीपेप्टाइड बॉन्ड टूटेगा और यहाँ से जो आपका एमिनो एसिड से वो आपके ट्राइसलिन के साथ जुड़ जाएगा. ये प्रोसेस कंटिन्यू इसमें चलती रहती है जैसा आप वीडियो में देख भी रहे हैं ये कंटिन्यूसली चल रहा है. एंड दिस वे थ्रू दिस दिस कैन बी कैपेबल टू मेक अ टोटल प्रोसेस ओवर देयर एंड आफ्टर दैट यू कैन जस्ट सी देयर इज अ स्टॉप कोडन विल कम हेयर at a site means this stop code initiated tell us that the process is completed of that particular synthesizing of the protein or translation process due to which they all will broken down and due to which we can say these are the releasing vector that is and they will all break down and after that it can be always helpful for the synthesizing that particular process over there.